The dream of the astronomers never gets old. There is always space to dream of bigger and bolder things that will change how we think about our world and ourselves. The year was great for science as we finally sent the James Webb Telescope into space. However, NASA is already looking to build 4 new telescopes that will help us understand our world even better. But of course, that depends on whether the space agency will select those proposals. All of this happens through the National Academy of Sciences. The Academy brings the scientific and astronomy community together to create the Decadal Survey on Astronomy and Astrophysics. The survey sets the astrophysics scientific priorities for the next decade. Many people think this is just a wish list, but it is much more than that. That is because Congress makes decisions related to budget once they see this survey. Various missions, such as the James Webb, Spitzer, Chandra, and others, took place because they were given the highest priority in the Decadal survey. Creating such a thing is not easy because it means one has to create the design and the vehicle that will fulfill the goals of the mission. According to the most recent Decadal survey, all 4 missions will operate at L2, where the JWST is right now. Let's take a look at all these 4 missions in great detail. Mission 1. HabEX. HabEX stands for the Habitable Exoplanet Observatory, and its main aim will be to directly image and characterize all the exoplanets like Earth for the first time. That is because the Kepler mission taught us that almost all stars host at least one planet. Out of these, at least 20% are like Earth. However, we have detected at least 6,000 exoplanets till now. Unfortunately, only a handful out of these thousands of planets have been directly imaged. The reason for this is that most of these planets are lost in the star's glare. So, the only way to directly image these stars is to block the light coming from the stars through a coronagraph. That is because planets, similar to Earth, are small and orbit closer to the stars. Because of this, the planet reflects 1/10 billionth of the parent star's light. Keeping this in mind, HabEX will use 2 spacecraft to image the exoplanets. The first spacecraft will be an optical telescope that will have a coronagraph. On the other, the second spacecraft will be a starshade of 52 diameters that will block the star. The telescope will also have a mirror of a 4-meter diameter that will collect light 10 times more than the Hubble. Besides that, it will also have an internal coronagraph that will be nothing like anything we have today. However, another problem is that the light from the stars entering the coronagraph also goes through a distortion because of even the slightest imperfections in the mirror of the telescope. If the coronagraph is not activated, such distortions will spread the light in concentric rings, and most of it will be at the center as blurred light. The name for this effect is diffraction. So, the coronagraph will use a special mask that will block the starlight and redirect most of it so that it does not block the beam's edges. After that, another disc will block the light at the beam's edges, and this will remove the rings. So, now that most of the light from the star is removed, it will be easier to directly image the planet. Besides that, the spectrometer of the telescope will also allow us to understand the exoplanet's atmosphere and the gases present there. The proposal of HabEX states that each spacecraft will have a separate launch. However, the most difficult part will be to launch the disk into space, which means the starshade will have to be folded up like origami and then unfolded. The HabEX and starshade will maintain a distance of over 76,000 kilometers and complement each other to look at the exoplanets in detail. Mission 2, the Lynx X-ray Observatory. The Lynx is the second proposal and the only one to probe our universe at the highest of energies. It will be an X-ray telescope that will be able to help us answer many things. First, however, you must remember that bringing the X-rays into focus needs a much more unique approach than other light forms. That is because if X-rays come into contact with a mirror at a shallow angle, they will deflect. Observatories such as the XMM Newton and Chandra solve this by arranging the mirror in concentric shells. However, Lynx will take all these things to the next level. For example, Chandra uses 4 shells of incidence mirrors. However, Lynx will use 12 metashells of thin mirrors that will be densely packed and created of various small modules. Because of this, Lynx will be 100 times more sensitive than Chandra. Of course, that is not a bad thing as it will enable Lynx to image faint X-ray sources that Chandra cannot. Lynx will work in such a way that it will detect high energy radiation emitting from the protostars that are deep inside their cocoons. Once that happens, it will allow astronomers to understand how high-energy radiation affects the formation and growth of these planets. Besides that, Lynx will also study the formation of the first galaxies and black holes inside our universe. It will also track and understand their evolution with time so we can have a better understanding of what took place during the early days of our universe. After all, understanding black holes, their growth, and evolution is still a question that we don't have answers to in the field of astronomy and astrophysics. The sensitivity of the Lynx is one of the biggest advantages we will have. That is because it will enable it to work incredibly fast while probing deep inside the universe than any other mission has ever gone. Lynx will be in direct competition with Chandra, as it will do everything Chandra can, but in great detail. That is because it will create much more detailed images and offer a wider field of view to us, so we can answer many mysteries about our universe. NASA plans that they will launch the Lynx soon because the design is based on Chandra, as it will have the same background and dimension. Lynx will be designed to operate for at least 20 years. However, the team will design it in such a way that it can be serviced by a robot, which can extend its lifespan in space. This transformational telescope will completely change the way we view things, and we can't wait for when this becomes a reality. Mission 3, the Origin Space Telescope. As the name suggests, this telescope will help us understand the history of our cosmos. We will be able to understand the formation of the first galaxies, and we will know how habitable worlds are created on our planet. Of course, fulfilling this aim will not be an easy task. That is why Origins will have an infrared telescope of 5.9 meters. Such dimensions will make Origins 1,000 times more sensitive than other telescopes, such as Herschel and Spitzer. Of course, this telescope will be much bigger, but it will still be smaller in size than the JWST. However, the key is to make Origins easy to build and deploy, so that it does not go over budget and does not take too long. By now, we know that infrared telescopes need to be in cold temperatures so they can detect heat signatures the universe is sitting. The temperature is kept cool by employing the use of cryocoolers and sunshades. However, these two objects can make the spacecraft heavy and bulky, which the agency does not want. The Origin team wants to go for a much bigger version of Spitzer that is easy to create and send into space. Once Origins is in its orbit, it will deploy the solar array, communication antenna, sunshield, telescope cover, and more. Origins will use a sunshield of 2 layers and a radiator. It will also have a surrounding barrel that will be painted black on one side and face deep space, while it will be highly reflected toward the sunshield on the other side. The black paint side will turn the bottom half of the telescope into a radiator, which will cool the barrel to 35K. Besides that, Origins will include one of the most advanced cryocooling systems to bring the temperature to 4.5K. The telescope will embark on some of the deepest spectroscopic surveys. These will enable the telescope to build a 3D map of our universe, trace galaxies, trace supermassive black holes, and help us understand our cosmic history. Here are some of the most important questions Origins will help us address. How do planetary systems form around stars? When do planetary systems form around their stars? What is the significance of water in the formation of a habitable planet? How are the ingredients of life, such as water, delivered to exoplanets and Earth? Of course, these are just some of the mysteries that Origins will help us resolve about our universe. The telescope is set up to be the infrared flagship mission that will follow the JWST. Mission 4, the LUVOIR, Large Ultraviolet Optical and Infrared Surveyor. If you think the JWST is the biggest telescope, you are in for a ride. That is because the LUVOIR aims to be the largest space telescope in the history of telescopes. It will be 15 meters, and the study will take into consideration at least 2 possible architectures for the telescope. Both of these design architectures will employ a massive sunshade that will keep all the sunlight away from the telescope and will ensure that it does not overheat. Keep in mind that the sunshade will follow the model of the sunshade in JWST, but LUVOIR does not require strict cooling, unlike the JWST. Because of this, the sunshade will be simple. That is because JWST is an infrared telescope, and because of this, the sunshade must keep the payload as cool as possible in space. Such an aim requires 5 layers that need to be spaced apart from one another and aligned properly with fine positioning mechanisms. On the other hand, the LUVOIR will be a near-IR and UV optical telescope. What this means is that the thermal requirements of this telescope will be much easier to meet, as the LUVOIR will only have 3 layers in its sunshade, unlike the JWST, which has 5 layers. Besides that, the layers of LUVOIR will not need perfect and precise alignment, which is why it does not require fine positioning mechanisms for its missions. However, creating a telescope is not that simple. That is because LUVOIR might have to point to the sunward hemisphere occasionally. Because of this, the sunshade of LUVOIR will be much larger, so that the telescope can stay in shadow when it begins pointing inward. The team of LUVOIR has a mandate to consider the design of a UV optical infrared telescope that should be in the range between 8 and 16 meters. So, the LUVOIR A proposal is that of a segmented mirror of 15 meters with a maximum of 4 instrument bays. The instrument will be big enough to fit inside the launch vehicle of SLS Block 2. On the other hand, the LUVOIR B design uses a mirror of 8 meters and 3 instrument bays. The ideal plan is to launch this telescope on the SpaceX Starship, SLS Block 1B, or the New Glenn. However, it will also easily fit inside an industry-standard fairing of 5 meters. So, the design of the LUVOIR B will be much more flexible as it will have one less instrument than A, and will also have a smaller aperture. Remember that the LUVOIR B will use an off-axis design that will require a secondary mirror to extend further than the primary. If the mission is successful, and we deploy the LUVOIR into space, we will get to know many things. For example, we could observe comets, Venus, exoplanets, and much more. LUVOIR will also be designed in such a way that it can be serviced and upgraded through modular design. It will also carry 10 years worth of consumables that will have to be replenished after this time frame. Besides that, the parts and components of the LUVOIR that cannot be serviced will be designed to last at least 25 years. Now, you might be wondering that both LUVOIR A and B are bigger than anything we have flown into space. So why are there two designs, and what is the advantage of A over B? Well, one of the primary aims of the LUVOIR is to look for habitable planets and understand their atmospheres in much greater detail. However, a planet like Earth is 10 billion times fainter than its host stars. Because of this, the exoplanets are some of the faintest objects in the universe we have ever come across. Looking at them and detecting images will require us to gather as much light as we possibly can. The ability of a telescope to collect light depends on the aperture square. For example, a 2-meter telescope can collect 4 times more light than a 1-meter telescope. The primary mirror of the Hubble is 2.4 meters. The mirror of HabEX will be 4 meters and collect 3 times more light than the Hubble. The mirror of LUVOIR B will be at 8 meters and it will collect 11 times more light. Finally, the LUVOIR A will have a 15-meter mirror, and it will collect 39 times more light than the Hubble telescope. The LUVOIR B design will help us detect at least 28 candidate exoplanets. On the other hand, the LUVOIR A design will help us detect more than 50 habitable exoplanet candidates. Because of this, we can finally understand if we are alone in the universe, or if there are other life forms out there that can also be classified as life. While detecting exoplanets and understanding them will be one goal of LUVOIR, another goal of this telescope will be to understand planetary systems, star formations, acceleration of the expansion of the universe, the earliest galaxies, and much more. The key to fulfilling this mission is to create a launch vehicle that will accommodate the LUVOIR. After all, it will be one of the biggest telescopes ever to launch into space. These are all the 4 missions that have been proposed. According to these proposals, the future of telescopes and observations looks highly interesting and fascinating. However, not all of these proposals will be selected to work on and launch. After all, there are limitations to budget, manpower, resources, and much more. One lucky proposal will get selected, and NASA will work on that so that we can understand our universe better. However, NASA and the entire scientific community will have to wait at least a year or two before one of the proposals gets selected from the list. Of course, that will be just the beginning of a new era in telescopes. Once the mission is selected, it will take at least 2 decades for the telescope to develop before it can launch into space. That is why we will see the fruits of these proposals during the 2030s. Until then, NASA is already busy with taking care of the telescopes it has sent into space for now. These include the WFIRST and JWST. We are yet to see what JWST will produce and the first images that it will send back to us after a few months. After all, the project took more than 2 decades, went well over budget, but it is finally at its destination where it will soon begin fulfilling its aim over the course of its lifetime. All the proposals look highly promising, and we hope that NASA chooses the best one that will help us understand everything much more deeply than anything else. What are the proposals you are excited about? Are you rooting for a specific telescope proposal to be selected so that you can have answers to the questions you ponder? If you are looking forward to a certain proposal, let us know in the comments below, because we would love to know what you think. If you found this video interesting and want more such information, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. You can join us in our journey of understanding astronomy, science, and all the missions taking place that will change what we know about our world and the others out there.